Lord, were we on for breakfast or lunch?
I'm sorry, Emily. You wouldn't believe the night I had in Landview. In fact, I barely made that early shuttle here to Boston. But I'm here plenty of time for Maggie's ceremony, right? Max. Hello, Max. What's going on? You don't look so hot.
Well, maybe it's a lack of sleep.
Too much thinking about Sister Maggie?
She's not a nun yet. She hasn't taken her vows.
She never should. Max, I don't know that that's your place to say anything about that.
Yeah, well, I already said something about it yesterday at the convent to her.
Max.
Look, I think she's making a big mistake. She doesn't know what she's giving up.
You mean you.
Oh, Maggie, Maggie, what are you doing here?
Pal, the name's not Maggie.
Sorry.
No kidding.
Well, come on, she looked like Maggie. I mean, from the back, come on.
They both have two legs.
You're a big help here. All right, okay. Then there's two possibilities in this circumstance. One is I'm slowly going insane from lack of sleep, or two, I'm already insane.
You know, Max, that lithium doesn't work unless you actually take it.
Very funny.
What's going on, Max? What's happening here? The white coats and a butterfly.
Oh, would you come on? I said, look, I'm not losing it.
You just accosted this young woman who's walking across here because you think she looks like Maggie Carpenter, which she doesn't.
Okay, well, we both know that Maggie is over at the convent preparing to take her vows.
All right, so I'm having a little hard time here knowing that she's going through with this.
Question is why, Max?
I don't know. I don't know. And, you know, she comes to Landview and it's like, we can't stand each other. Then I get a pie in the face, a couple drinks in my lap, and things change. I don't know. I got to the point where I think she might be all right.
What? We both know how attracted you are to her.
Oh, can you blame me? Her walking around in those tight sweaters all the time? Oh, and the real kick in the head is when she says, oh, by the way, hands off, I'm gonna be a nun. Yeah, right, like I'm supposed to believe that. Look, I let her call the shots, I backed off.
And why did you keep spending that kind of time with her?
Not romantically.
Oh, no, you just spent time together as what is, very good friends. Like the way she helped you deal with the fact that Frankie was dead? The way you piled her in the car, you drove to North Carolina with them so the twins could spend some time with Luna's family? And then what, that little excursion you had, the Lantano Mountain, and the fire, and the roasted marshmallows, and you brought a boombox too, right? So you could dance a little bit. So what is that? That's just good, clean, American fun with a nun.
Okay, all right. Okay, so it wasn't so innocent. But that's my point. I mean, we're up there, we're dancing in the firelight, and I'm thinking things you should never be thinking about a nun. But she's right there. She knew what she was getting into. She wanted to be there. I mean, she's in my arms. The tape's playing this great song. I'm looking in her eyes and I just know she feels something.
Maybe you just wish that you were, Max. Have you fallen in love with Maggie?
What I feel about Maggie. I don't know what I'm doing here in Boston. I don't know anything anymore. What are we sitting here talking about a soon-to-be nun who gets her kicks by jumping in a pool fully clothed?
What are you saying, Max? What's your point? That nuns aren't allowed to have fun? Or if they do have fun, they're not allowed to look sexy when they come up out of the pool and they got those tight clothes on.
Oh, please, would you stop? I've had enough trouble getting that image out of my mind already.
Max, you wanted her. She didn't want you back. That happens, all right? It happens all the time. Sometimes the good ones get away. But life goes on, all right? You find somebody else, you have a life with them.
No, see, this is different. I've loved and lost before. I know it sounds very hard to believe, but it's true. It was never like this. I don't know, this is like taking a step off the edge of a cliff.
I'm sorry, just hold on 1 second. Yeah, Court Roberts. Oh, great. No, I'm just a few minutes away. I'll be there in a few minutes, okay? Hold on. Bye. Look, there's been a little snafu at the Boston office. I gotta go. Are you gonna be okay?
I will. This coffee shop starts serving bloody bowls.
Listen, Max, considering the circumstances, you might want to skip Maggie's ceremony today.
I might.
If you catch a shuttle back home, I'll see you in my view.
Yeah, okay, I'll see you quick.
in a church in downtown. Oh, I got down on my knees and prayed, and I wept in the arms of Jesus for the choice he made. We were just getting to the good part, just getting past the mystery. Oh, and it's just like you, it's just like you to disagree.
Max?
Maggie?
Hi.
Maggie, what are you doing here?
Well, I could ask you the same question. I thought that you left Boston.
No, I didn't. What's your answer? I mean, why are you here? Aren't you supposed to be in church?
Oh, yeah. Actually, I am.
Well, but you're not. You're... What does that mean? Is that... Did you change your mind?
I'm still going to be a nun.
Oh.
I thought that was pretty clear to you, the way you stormed out of the convent yesterday, telling me that I should go on and have a nice life. I mean, why would you ask me?
Maggie, listen, lighten up, huh? I was just kidding, all right?
Oh, you were?
Yeah, I mean, if anybody got that message from the nun, it's me.
Well, then why are you here?
Why am I here?
Yeah, Boston.
I love Boston, but I take the Freedom Trail every time I come through town. No, really, I just need to get some rest before I head back to PA. I was up all night for the day tracking you down.
Yeah, right.
No, but you, oh, by the way, that's why I snapped at you. I'm a bit of a bear when I don't get much sleep. Please, I hope you'll forgive me for that. I really do. I really do wish you a nice life. Oh, and a very nice perpetual motion ceremony.
Oh, no, it's a perpetual profession.
What?
It's called a perpetual profession ceremony.
Oh, well, I guess before I make an even bigger jerk of myself, I'd hit the road.
Max, I really hope you'll be happy for me. I'm absolutely positively sure that this is what I want and that it's right for me.
Then why are you trembling?
Well, I think that my hands are shaking because, hey, it's my big day.
Sure it's nothing else?
Yeah, well, my father's meeting me here.
Oh, really? Bishop decided to come.
Yeah, the impossible happened. It's pretty neat, huh? Yeah. Of course, you know, the old windbag could bail at the last minute. Who knows?
No, the old windbag isn't going to bail.
Daddy. You made it.
Of course.
I knew this was an important day for you, so I came. I always thought I was a pompous old windbag. Has something changed?
Oh, come on now, don't embarrass me.
Look, I need to leave. It was nice seeing you.
No, Max, wait. Just... Could you just give us a minute, Daddy?
Of course.
Thanks. Look, this is turning out to be an even more important day than I thought, and...
And what?
And I know that you said no, but I really want you to stay for the ceremony.